element of innovation and motivation. I would like to start my talk with the quote, Peter's never win, winners never quit. I'm from a very poor family. Whereby my parents did not have much to sponsor me for my education and for my projects. So I had an innovator started from an incinerator. From an incinerator to an innovator, I went to the scene of invention. When I was 10 years old, I discovered that a special attraction to scrap material. I picked up scrap material to make money back from school when I was in primary school. With this abandoned waste item that I picked up from the incinerator, I designed a magnetic curriculum that was how I laid my two hands on the path to the invention. I remember when I was in primary school, my mates and my colleagues, they do their own. They are just people who can't read my rights. What are you doing for? I said, how to do something to continue to be a student so that I don't feel I won't drop out from school. Then I started picking up things from the resume, prepare electronics, synthesis reviews, just like for my colleagues who have to give something to check. Sometimes I give $5, $10. I don't think that's very small amount of money because I believe my parents don't really give me money. Then I started picking up myself from there. Innovation therefore is my own analyzed innovation. After the design of my magnetic paper, I started thinking of other ideas that today have resulted in the design of the charging blender, Footmat Alarm, solar powered lawnmower, and solar powered grinder specification. I met one of my mentors, first of all, Mr. Ishola, because you are the best contributor to my life, to my story, and also some of Microsoft innovative teachers, person of Mr. Ayanwoye Tobi Rasheed, and my mentor also, Mr. Tanko, who brings me along whenever I'm doing my technical work. And also, I really appreciate my principal and my colleagues that also do contribute to my project. Then in 2013, there was a competition that was coming up into my school, organized by the school of my grade. My employee went for the first level at the campus. They came back with nothing. Then in the club meeting, they said, you know you are not able to represent to me, can you see me? Then I went up there and I said, I can do something. Who are you? He repeated, you can't do anything, you are nobody. Then I told my teacher, then my sister, and I said, ma'am, can you just give me one opportunity to do this? If I was not going to go to the hour opportunity to do something like this again. She said, okay, let's try it. Then I started, I told her I want to design the solar power lawnmower. She said, are you sure you can do it? I said, yes, ma'am. I designed the solar power lawnmower because then every Wednesday, my teacher, my senior colleagues then, they send us out to be free, the school free to go and cut the grass. Sometimes my school paid the laborers to come and cut. Then I thought of, wow, for my school paying this every day, every week, every month, I can come up with something better to change the world, to change my school, to change my community, to change my state, to change Nigeria. I said, okay, I'm going to design this solar power lawnmower. As we all know, the lawnmower we are using right now in Nigeria, let me say, in African countries, they are bad, they are worse. We use petrol for them and it makes a lot of noise. Whereby people in the community, whenever they are using it, they feel so bad that it's annoying and so much better. Then I designed the solar powered lawnmower, add a rechargeable battery, and also an headlight in which you can make use of it at night, very early in the morning. And the most important and most funniest part of this lawnmower is that add a customized lock system. You can make use of it whenever you want to. Whenever you want to lock it, okay, well, I don't want my neighbor to use this lawnmower. Let me lock it. You can lock it and take your key out of it. For that call to 2013 to represent my school. When I got there, I didn't go for the first level, so I went for the second level. The coordinator said, are you sure you are going to move? I said, I can, and I will. I said, okay, let's try it. Then I went to my presentation, then I was dyslexic. I didn't have opportunity to be able to read what I've written down or what they are putting down for me as a presentation. Then my mentor then this. Two, it's time to read all the presentation in a voice note, get it on the memory card, then I'll start with the memory card, then I'll do the MDs, listen to my presentation, and then after this presentation, I to get it, to talk. Then when I got there, you always tell me something, never give up, and never give up. Then I walked in, told, never give up, never give up. When I got to the stage, I said, good day everyone, my name is Tobi Ayanwoye, a.k.a. ATRA THE INNOVATOR, student of Federal Government College Ogbomoso, University. Then I didn't remember what to say to me. I was like, what am I going to start? Then I started for my protest. I didn't even bother to look at the presentation or whatever. I just said my protest. I started explaining everything to them. And nobody knew that I was the next day, because I was unable to be, and I don't want to support me for myself after my school. Then I didn't know. Then I started from there, I took third position for my school, and I was the first in the history of my school that a student who represents my school, I will come up with an award, and also that I'm going to win something very big for my school. Our chemistry lab was innovated with a lot of equipment and laptops, systems, and so on. Yeah. I came up with the idea of a Footmat Alarm. I believe everyone wants to know what we call Footmat Alarm. Something like that we put that enter the world. And I said, yeah, don't really have security. Can I just come up with something better? I said, okay, let me design a Footmat Alarm. The Footmat Alarm will be put at the end of the world. Even the other person knows, you know, you step on the car to ring this and you know that there's someone who's up there.
Thank you all for listening to me.